Assalamu alaikum. In the last video, we defined Hermitian operator and studied the properties of Hermitian operator. Today, in the examples, we will show that the position and the momentum operators are Hermitian operator. We defined that an operator omega hat is said to be Hermitian if it follows this equation. That is, if it can be taken from the second function to the first function in this way. We also studied that the Hermitian operator has real expectation value and the eigenvalues of the Hermitian operator are also real. The eigenfunctions of the Hermitian operator can be organized so that they satisfy orthonormality, that is, they can be normalized and the overlap between the two eigenfunctions is zero. Also, the eigenfunctions of the Hermitian operator form a complete set of basis functions, so that with the superposition of the eigenfunctions, a reasonable wave function can be written. Here are some examples of the operators. This is position operator. P hat is the momentum operator. This is the kinetic energy operator. And H hat is the Hamiltonian operator. And in quantum mechanics, there are a lot more. So when the operator acts on the wave function, it gives us the observable or the eigenvalues. We use this brief notation, or the integrals of the two functions is written with this notation. And if A are a complex constant, then when A is multiplied with the first function, if we want to take it out, we have to take its complex conjugate out. If it are multiplied with the second function, then there's no problem. We can just take it out. It can be understood from this one, this definition. If A are here multiplied with phi, then since the complex conjugate of phi is used of the first function, then it will be here A star. But if it are multiplied with the second function, psi, then it's simply the same as it is. With this notation, we say that Hermitian operator follows this rule. If we have a negative sign, when we take it from the second function to the first function, then we say that omega hat is anti-Hermitian. Now we want to show that the position operator is a Hermitian operator. To do that, we evaluate this integral. So here the x hat is acting on psi. But from the definition of the position operator, we know that when the position operator acts on a function, it simply means that we multiply x with that function. So from this line, we write like this. Now, this can be viewed as the product of three functions, phi star, x, and psi. Since they are simply functions, we can change their order. So we write like this. Now, x is a real quantity. So if we take the complex conjugate of it, it will be the same. So with the complex conjugate, we write like this. Now we again use the definition so that we have x hat phi. Now from the definition, this is equal to this. That means when x hat acting on the second function, it is same if x hat acting on the first function. So by the definition, we conclude that the position operator x hat is Hermitian operator. Now we want to show that the momentum operator is also Hermitian operator. We do the same to show that, but we know that P hat equals minus I a square d by dx. So we use the definition here and we take minus I a hat a square out. So we have this one. Now we integrate by parts to evaluate these integrals and we arrive in this line. We know that as x goes to infinity, the wave function must become zero. So the first term on the right side is equal to the zero. Therefore, we are left with this. If I take the ih cut inside this complex conjugate, so we write like this one, because here complex conjugate is used, so I use minus I. But by definition, this is p hat, so we have finally p hat phi and psi. So again, from the definition, we see that since we can take p hat from the second function to the first function, p hat is also Hermitian operator. So we have shown that the position and momentum operators are Hermitian operator. It can be also shown that the d by dx is anti-Hermitian and d square by dx square is Hermitian. By showing this, we can also show that the kinetic energy operator is also Hermitian operator. I leave it as a homework for the students. That's all for today. Thank you.